Planet Dolan.
From why animals have tails to what would happen if the sun disappeared, we answer some of your most burning questions about life.
Hey there, my name is Doopy, and I'll be reading... Oh no, no, not you!
Oh, hey, Doopy. My friend, my compadre, my home slice. Looks like we'll be reading out these questions and answers together today, huh? Yeah, that's pretty cool. Yeah.
All right, Gurgak. Well, you just stand over there. Don't touch me, and let's get this over with. Blue the Raptor 1 asks, what is the fastest car that is street legal?
Ooh, mama. Okay, now let me tell you. I got the loadout on a hot car out on the streets. This car has been in outer space. It's ridden on the backs of dinosaurs. It's even been in a parade. I remember back in the day, I was just a wee child. The car, the hoopty, the one and only Putt-Putt.
That's a video game.
Shut up, Doopy. You dream crusher. Jokes, my bestie. Hugs, kisses. Ooh.
The fastest car by top speed is the Bugatti Veyron Supersport, which holds the official Guinness World Record at 268 miles per hour. The Hennessy Venom GT was recorded at going 270 miles per hour, but it was not recognized by Guinness. The Porsche 918 Spyder is the quickest car, going from 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 2.2 seconds. Undead King 243 asks, why can't birds see glass?
Man, don't question it. That's good meat falling down from those windows. Mm-mm. Bird steak, bird salad, bird burgers. Oh yeah.
Oh, God! Oh, someone please call an ambulance!
Oh, the ambulance is on their way. Delicious bird woman.
Birds, just like humans, cannot see glass. Humans, though, can interpret reflections or markings on the glass, letting us know that it's there. Birds, however, see what is reflected back as the actual outside world, and in some cases will even attack their own reflection. Ugh! Okay, Gurgak, where is she? What did you do to her?
God, how dare you accuse me of eating that sultry buttered flesh?
Hey! Right here, Doopy. That bite actually helped snap my wing back into place. Guess I owe you some thanks then, Gurgak.
Yes, thank you. I'm still going to eat you.
II Gold Female II asks, can sound frequencies actually change our eye color?
Oh, absolutely, my dudes. It's all in the ear of the beholder. Most music is trash. It's trash, we all know it. But check out this hot track I recorded. It is literally burning. Oh, yes. Oh. Beautiful. Exquisite. Ooh, it's a masterpiece.
No, sound frequencies, especially from a set of speakers, cannot change a person's eye color. The color of the iris is produced by the pigment known as melanin and is determined by our genes. Although, babies can be born with blue eyes, which change to brown after a year. Shiny Donovan asks, when was the Ouija board invented?
Ouija? Garbage. Budget 8 balls with no magic. It has one use, man. One use. Alright, magic Ouija board. Who is she? Who is my best friend? It's, a D? Oh, man. Oh, an O.
Gurgak, stop.
Doopy, look at this. Look, you won't believe it. It's another O. Oh, wow. What a surprise, huh?
No.
Wait. An L? Dolan? Dolan?
Really?
No. It's you. Yeah, it's you.
Ugh. Elijah Bond patented the Ouija board in 1890. 4 years prior, in 1886, there were reports of talking boards in Ohio very similar to the modern Ouija board. William Fold then took over the business and in 1901 made the boards under the name Ouija, which he got by combining the French and German words for yes. Nessie the Loch Ness Monster asks, why do we call it sand? Is it because it's between the sea and the land?
No way, dude! You are blowing my mind! Fun fact though, sand is a natural eye lubricant. Throw it at drowning people and it'll make them see even better. How do you think the lifeguards, you know, guard your life? Sand, baby.
Swim towards the loudspeaker music. You'll be fine.
No, sand is not called sand because it's between the sea and the land. It's derived from other languages, such as Proto-Germanic, and so doesn't come from two English words. Sand also refers to the grains themselves and can be found in places besides the seaside. Kurushimi asks, what is the largest known word in English?
The largest word in the entire English language is actually not a word at all. It's...
The chemical name for the chitin protein, although not listed in the dictionary, is 189,819 letters in length. Pneumono ultramicroscopic silica volcanoconiasis is the longest word in the dictionary at 45 letters. The longest word published contains 1,909 letters.
It means hello in the Russian.
Zach Blade asks, what's the role of a tail to animals?
Tails aren't real. Come now, you know what they're from.
Erotic roleplay?
Like this.
Oh yeah, you like the waggling of that tail? You like being pet, pet like a dog, you filthy animal.
It's sensual. It's hot. Doopy and I roleplay all the time.
No! That has never happened! That will never happen! Disgusting and gross!
Oh, you're getting my tail all feathery. Come, Doopy. Come to Daddy.
Animals use their tails in a variety of ways, as it can play a different role depending on the species. Animals commonly use it as a way to balance, as a mating display, as a warning system, to propel them through water, and others can grab things with it. Some dogs use it to curl around them while they sleep, keeping them warm. Yvette Diaz asks, what makes a person's hair naturally curly, straight, or wavy?
Oh, these curls that I have? Oh yeah, just natural.
Yeah, right. Your hair is nothing but grease.
Hey! Grease is all natural, drips straight off the meat. It's all about using every part of the animal. It's kind of like a respect thing, Doopy.
No, really, it's...
No. Shh. Now, Doopy, you need to see where I'm coming from.
Ugh. Oh, I'm seriously going to puke. How straight, curly, or wavy your hair is depends on your genetics. It is estimated that 85 to 95% comes down to your parents' genes. This will determine the shape and angle of the follicles, the parts of the skin that the hair emerges from. The angle of the follicle dictates if it's curly or not. What would happen if the sun disappeared for 5 seconds?
Doopy, I got a personal question. I gotta ask you. It's really important.
What?
Alright, the sun is gone. It's cold. Everyone died. They're dead. Just you and me. It's freezing. You'll die, okay? But there's a way out. A solution. Here it is.
Oh god.
Okay, for 5 seconds, just 5, we huddle for warmth. Yes or no?
If the sun disappeared for 5 seconds, it probably wouldn't be long enough to have any great impact.
Doopy.
We wouldn't even see the sun go out until 8 minutes after it happened because of the time it takes for the light to travel to Earth.
Doopy, yes or no?
The sun's absence would mean the planets would drift off into space. However, this wouldn't happen immediately since gravity also travels at the speed of light.
Please, this god, I'm so lonely.
You are like so pathetic. Alright. Here, I'll pat you.
Oh hello.
This video was made possible by our fans over on Patreon. Thanks for your support, guys. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a cool one!